Hello. In this video, we'll show you how to fine-tune Google's PaLM 2 large language model so that it better fits your specific context and use case. This is a really powerful concept in that it allows customization of these really expensive to build and train models, but does so in a pretty lightweight way. Furthermore, we don't even need to have complex code or advanced machine learning algorithms to do this fine-tuning. This is exposed for us in a very simple and easy-to-use way. All we will really need is a training data file that has input text and output text that teaches the model the kinds of outputs that we like for our inputs. Ultimately, both our fine-tuning dataset and the base model will be fed into a serverless and no-code fine-tuning pipeline, where our model will then be deployed so that our various software systems can use it. This can be in Google Cloud or anywhere else that can use the API for our model. Now, I want to emphasize at the beginning here that there are some really important quota, TPU, and cost considerations when you look at this fine-tuning approach. So, if you're like the type of viewer that likes to follow along in real time, we actually recommend that you wait a little bit, fully understand all the cost-benefit trade-offs and nuances, and then if you decide this makes sense for you, watch the video again and follow along in real time. We want to make sure that you're not surprised by any of the technical details, important nuanced configurations, or the cost model here. With that said, let's go ahead and go into the Google Cloud Console to start setting this up, and we'll also use a Cloud Shell IDE for drafting some JSON files. So in our project, let's go to Vertex AI and then to the Generative AI Studio. From here, we have this Create Tuned Model button where we can then upload that data set that we're talking about. Now it's recommended that we have at least 100 to 500 samples. However, this isn't a strict or hard requirement and we will use a file with significantly fewer examples. Let's create that now in an IDE. Again, we've got input and output pairs, and the idea here is perhaps that we want the model to learn that we're in the New York City area. So, for example, when we ask, "Where can I find the best street food?" without any additional context in our prompt, we want the model to be able to know that New York City specific results should be returned. So we have about a dozen examples here, and we can download this file and then use it in that fine-tuned model interface. For the dataset location, we'll create a new bucket, and we can just call this something like PaLM fine-tuning. Note that these names need to be globally unique and should not contain sensitive information. The defaults should be fine for all the other configuration points. Great, so we've provided our file, we've provided a bucket, and then if we continue along here, we'll just be setting some additional properties around the model. Note that text bison is one of the sizes of the PaLM 2 model and at present is our only option for fine-tuning. For the working directory, we're going to choose that exact same bucket, and then in the model name, we'll say PaLM fine-tuning NYC. Now, in general, you probably want to start with the defaults here, 100 training steps and a learning rate of 3. However, to have a very simple example that's low cost for demonstration's sake, we're going to do just a single training step. And we'll click to start tuning. Okay, so here we have our new fine-tuning job, and we're going to track that for the time being, but we can also quickly go to one of those pipelines. Now, what's really nice about these fine-tuning jobs is that they're built on the same pipelining and training services and infrastructure that you may be used to with Google Cloud already. That is, when I click in here, for example, to this pipeline, we see the nice Vertex AI Pipelines interface. And we can even look into the various jobs to see additional details around specific compute provisioning and parameters. Those details can also be seen in the training interface here, which is really where each of these modular tasks are executed. For our fine-tuning jobs, that's typically going to be in the custom job section, and specifically the Europe West 4 region. We can see our job here, and we'll have more and more stack up as we create them. But back in the pipelines, let's go to our pipeline run and talk through a couple of other concepts. First off, we have a number of pretty lean validating and input-output processing tasks here, such as for exporting data and doing some validations and conversions. However, this task here, the large language model tuner, is going to be the major one. Now, once we reach this point in the training job, we'll actually see the type of hardware that this consumes, but this is going to be where the bulk of your cost is probably going to lie when you're creating these fine-tuned models. This also has important quota implications, and so once our pipeline reaches this step, we'll look at a couple of those concepts and also talk about the cost model here. We'll just give this pipeline a couple of minutes to get to that point. And now that we've hit that step, if I go to the view job, we can see what's backing this step in our pipeline. And there are a couple of very important things to take note of. First off, we have 64 cores of version 3 TPU powering this training step, so this is pretty accelerator heavy and is naturally going to carry a relatively high per hour cost. We will look at the cost model and quota implications in just a moment, but here we can also see things like some command line flags that we see were specified on our behalf by Google, like the adapter length here. This is some sort of adapter-based approach for fine-tuning the GPT-3 model. If we look at the quotas for this project and sort by current usage, we see a 100% use of our TPU V3 cores quota for Europe West 4. We can infer from this that if we want to run two different pipelines for fine-tuning in parallel, we'll need to increase this quota, which we can just do by selecting and then editing the quota here. Now, just as important as the quota implications, here are the cost implications for all these TPUs. So if we go to the Google Cloud cost calculator, which we'll link in the description of this video, and put 32 chips, which means 64 cores, for version 3 TPUs, the TPU pod type, and no commitment duration, we'll be able to get the cost estimate. For the 64 cores that we're running here, we see a pretty high monthly cost. The price is by hour though, and this is a serverless service, so the more important number is probably the per hour cost, about $64 per hour. We found that these training jobs tend to run within 10 minutes or so if you have about a dozen examples and a single training step. If you bump up those training steps to 100 and use the minimum recommended examples count of 100 to 500, you could get a significantly longer runtime and therefore significantly more accelerator usage and cost. So do keep in mind this relatively high cost and high quota usage whenever you're running these fine-tuning pipelines. And with that job now completed, we can check out the logs for additional detail around the fine-tuning. The next two steps are uploading that new fine-tuned model to the model registry in Vertex AI, where we can track and manage it. And then it's actually going to do a deployment for us automatically to a Vertex AI endpoint, so we're really getting the full experience of not just fine-tuning the model here, but also productionizing it. And we'll see in just a moment how we can actually use this model now that it's deployed. And now that we've got a successful deployment, we can actually use this hyperlink to check out the new model, and specifically, this is going to be in the model registry portion of the Vertex AI console. If we click in here, we see that, although we don't have any evaluation controls, we can deploy it and can see that it has already been deployed to one real-time prediction endpoint. Interestingly, it's actually been deployed to US Central 1. So we can use this endpoint like other Vertex AI endpoints, which is a really flexible approach for real-time AI/ML applications. Or, as alluded to in that deploy and test interface, we can also use this in the Generative AI Studio. So if I click to open in the prompt design, we can actually have our model here and use it in the same way that we use the base models themselves in the Generative AI Studio. And from here, we can query our new fine-tuned model. Note that our model will follow the same usage and pricing as if we were using the base model. So if I go to View Code, for example, there's a spot for the tuned model name. It's pretty quick and easy to use our new tuned model in Python code, for example, in our custom AI-powered applications. Similarly, we can use just a pure API call if we needed a language-agnostic way to use our new model. We'll keep an eye on the comments section for any questions or comments, and want to thank you for watching.